Hi, welcome to another edition of Finding Aza. Today, we'll be talking about commitment. Have you ever promised to do something for someone and later discovered that following through was more difficult than anticipated? Many of us have found ourselves in that position. Usually, there are two options: go forward or renege. It is far easier to say, "I cannot come and go and kill myself," as is often said in Nigerian parlance, or "Jesus didn't die for this," as we beat a hasty retreat. But each time you do not follow through, each time you break a commitment, you're saying you do not have what it takes to find Aza. And you do want to find Aza, don't you? Let's take a look at some statistics that has to do with commitment. In the United States in 2018, 73% of marriages ended because one partner felt the other was not committed to the relationship. That is, of every 10 marriages that ended in divorce, 7 cited lack of commitment as a reason. Mostly, it is the women that complain that their husbands were not committed. There's a biological reason for this. The higher levels of oxytocin produced by women means that by nature they are more predisposed to commitment. Men have a harder time with this quality. Their drive is influenced by a need to be responsible for someone. A friend of mine once said that when a person is committed to another in a relationship, they're willing to take actions that are consequential, even risky. They show their partner that they are ready to lose something. Let's think about this for a moment. We can compare commitment to an investment. When you go into a venture, you are convinced there will be profit. But this is not a 100% guarantee. There is a likelihood that you might fail. You calculate the odds and then decide whether it is worth the risk, and then you invest. When you do invest, you do everything in your power to make sure that your investment turns out a success, including investing more time and resources sometimes. You do not consider declaring bankruptcy at the very first sign of trouble, except maybe you didn't conduct due diligence at the start. Even at that, you know you will suffer the consequences of your decisions. You know you will lose something if you break your commitment. This is what commitment means in marriage. Commitment is a show, not a tell quality. That you will do everything in your power to ensure that the relationship works. You do not plan to fail. Even though divorce can be an option, you do not see it as an open option or something to be easily explored. So, how do you learn commitment while you're still single? The short answer is, always finish what you start, no matter how difficult it might seem. The longer answer is, ensure that whatever you choose to start is what you will finish. Remember the investment analogy? When you forget special days, when you do not pay attention to things that make people around you happy, when you do not show up for their special occasions, when you're not by their side to hold their hands through troubled times, when you text rather than call and call rather than visit, when you promise to work with them on a project and go back on your word, then you're showing a lack of commitment. Fix up, or you will end up as the 7 out of 10. And that's it on Finding Aza at this time. In our next part, we'll examine the ways that you can learn commitment if you realize it's a quality missing in your life. Don't forget to hit the subscribe and notification button. Links to studies referenced in this part will be found in the description area. Let's keep the conversation going on social media. Comment, like, and share, and we'll talk again soon.